I'm Mike from Regala Photography, where we talk about everything photography. Today I have a quick trick using the histogram in Adobe Lightroom Classic to help you edit your exposure on all your photos. Understanding the histogram is essential for achieving an accurate exposure and making precise adjustments to your photos. So let's jump right into this topic. Before we get started, let's briefly explain what a histogram is and what it does. In simple terms, a histogram is a graphical representation of the tonal distribution of an image. It displays the distribution of brightness levels from shadows to highlights, and it helps you analyze and adjust the exposure of your photos. In Lightroom Classic, the histogram can be found in the top right-hand corner of the develop module. The left side over here of the histogram represents your shadows and blacks. And then the right side over here represents the highlights and whites. The middle portion of the histogram represents your midtones. The height represents, or actually corresponds with the number of pixels at that particular tonal level. So as you can see for this particular photo, there are a lot of blacks and darks in the video. And if you look, there's hardly any highlights in whites, but we're going to change that. Okay. This is why we shoot in RAW. Okay. What we're going to do though, is that we're going to focus mainly on, on the ends of the histogram over here. So we're going to focus on the darks and shadows, and then we're also going to focus on the highlights and the whites. Okay. What we want to do is avoid either one of them bunching up to the ends. As you can see, again, with this photo, the darks are really bunched up over here in the end. And what's happening is they are being clipped. And as you can see, I have my monitor on here for the highlights and then for the darks. And you can see the sun represented here with the red is blown out. So there's no data. Wherever that red is right there, there's no data. Now it's the sun, so you usually, if you take a picture of a sun like that, you're not gonna have any data in there anyway, so I'm not too concerned about that. But then if you look down in here, you can see the blue, and that represents where the blacks are being clipped, okay? And there's no data there, it's pure black. And you really don't, for some photos you might want pure black, but for the most part, you really don't want to have pure black in most of your photos, okay? So you can see here, the blue represents where it is pure black. So we're going to focus over here on the two ends mostly. Now, if you haven't noticed yet, when I hover my cursor over the histogram, you'll see it highlights. And what's highlighting is, like right here in the middle, I'm highlighting the midtones, okay? And if I highlight over here, this is the highlights in this little section. And then over here, this is pure white, is where I'm highlighting pure white. And then if I go on this side over here, this particular section is the shadows. And then all the way over here, this is pure black. And again, you can see that this particular photo, there's a lot of pure black here, okay? And we're gonna fix that in a minute. Now, if you click and drag on any one of those sections, you're gonna see that it's gonna change the corresponding slider, okay? It kind of takes the place of the slider, but this allows you to see what part of the photo you're actually affecting with your sliders. So I come up here, okay? I'm highlighted over the midtones. I am going to click and I'm going to drag over to the right, and you can see the midtones are getting brighter. Now, if I go too far, you can see I'm blowing out my whites, and you can see how the histogram, everything shifted over to the right now, which means I am losing data in my highlights and whites, which you don't want. So I want to kind of bring it back a little bit. All right. And you can see I kind of took away from the blacks a little bit, pulled it away, which is good. It's what you want. And then I also brought the whites and highlights a little closer, which is good. You don't want everything all in the middle, or you could. Actually, that's probably almost a perfect photo if you have everything all kind of here in the midtones. But that's kind of hard to do, especially in a high dynamic range photo, like a sunset. So that was with the midtones. So I'm going back and forth with the midtones. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of go a little bit more right there. Okay. And again, we can fix this later with masking. We can go in and mask out the sky, and I can, you know, fine tune with some local adjustments. But for right now, this is going to be the whole photo. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come on over here to my pure blacks, and I'm going to bring them to the right and brighten them up a little bit. And you can see how they've brightened right there. And then I'm going to move over here to the shadows and again, pull them over to the right and brighten them up a little bit. And now you can see how this whole area right here, okay? You can see here's the before, okay? And here's the after. Now we can see the beach, well, the beach, if you want to call it that, but the rocks and the logs and stuff. You can actually see the detail that was actually there, again, because I shot this in RAW, okay? And now I'm going to come back over here, and I'm going to take the highlights, and I'm going to bring them to the left a little bit. Because again, it's a sunset, so I want to bring out that detail in the sunset and not have them blown out. But at the same time, I got my whites here, and I'm going to brighten them up just a tad, a little bit. And now if you look at my histogram, excuse me, if you look at my histogram, you can see how I don't have any pure black in the histogram over here anymore. Let me click that right there. Oops. So you can see nothing is clipped. Now I do have some pure white, but again, it is the sun, so I'm not really too concerned with having detail in the sun. You kind of want to almost exaggerate that a little bit to show the glow from the sun. So again, now you can see over here my sliders, they're already moved. I don't have to go one at a time. I did them up here, and it was a visual representation of the tones, the luminosity of my photo. So I brought up my shadows and my blacks, and I brought down my highlights, and I did actually bring down the whites too, even though it's still blown out over here. I did bring the highlights down. You can see there's more detail again. Before, after. Now, what I would normally do then is, you know, finish up all my other global adjustments. And then what I would do is I would come into my masks, and let me go click the sky, and I will click the sky right there. And then now what I will do is bring my highlights down a little bit. Now you can see I got that warm tone in there, those colors. I might even bring my exposure down just a little bit. Okay. Whites, just to get that glow. All right. I'm going to warm it up just a little bit. With this particular photo, I don't want to go too crazy. This particular night, it was a very hazy evening. Out in the distance, Canada is actually on the other side. This is Lake Ontario. And there are the Canadian wildfires going on, and the haze from the fires were actually affecting our sunset over here. I'm going to add a tiny bit of magenta, all right? And then I'm going to bring up my saturation a little bit there, okay? And now what I'm going to do also is my clarity. Oh, here's what a little trick I like to do. I bring the clarity up a little bit to define the clouds, but then I bring the texture down, and it softens those edges. So I still have the definition or the contrast of the clouds, but I soften them up, but they don't look fake or like drawn or over sharpened. Okay. So it's a little trick there. And, you know, again, there's my sky. All right. Now, what else I would probably do with this particular photo, just real quick, take a radial gradient, and I want to bring just this area up a little bit. So let me move this over a little bit, bring up my exposure just to bring up those houses. Oh, wait a minute. That was texture. My bad. Get that out of there. Bring up my exposure. I was wondering why that wasn't doing much. So there's my exposure. And then bring up my shadows just a loop. Too much. Bring up my whites. Okay, and then a little bit of saturation. I like to give it a little warmth because the sun is actually coming through these trees here. And this always gets really a little bit on the warm side. So I want to do that. And then now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up my clarity and bring up my texture. All right. And then we got that right there. And let me see, what else can we do with this photo? What we can do is we can give ourselves a little bit of a vignette. So we could take the radial and we can make a radial through the center here. And we'll put that almost right in the middle there. Let's bring that down and then we're gonna bring this up a little bit to the edges there. And then what I want to do is invert it and then bring my exposure down just a little bit like that. And you can see it's going to put the focus right there. But another little trick, take the radial again, another one, make it a little smaller right here in the center. Okay. And I kind of actually shifted over just a little bit towards these houses over here. And I'm going to brighten that up just a little bit there. You can see how this right here, some light being shown onto these houses. I'm going to warm it up just a bit. A little bit of magenta. Okay, not too much. And then we're going to bring up some saturation. And pretty much we have our finished photo. Okay. And now if you look over here at my histogram, you could see all the detail has been brought closer to the middle. There is very little. There's that one little peak right there of pure white, and that is the sun. There's a little bit down here as well, but that is the sun right there. But you can look over here. There is no pure black, maybe very, very little, very little. Okay, so it's no pure black, and it becomes more of a pleasing photo. So, excuse me, if I go before and then after, you can see the difference. Here's my before, okay? And here is the after. A much, much more natural looking photo, okay? Using the histogram will allow you to get your photos closer to natural, or at the very least to a neutral profile to use as a baseline. And then you can add color grading and local adjustments through masks, as you saw in the photo that I edited. If you found this video helpful, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. It really does help. Ring that bell so you'll be notified when my next video is posted. Until next time, take care, everyone.